Up next, if you aren't quite ready for a smartwatch to monitor your every move, there are some buzzworthy apps in the health and fitness space. Joining us with some highlights is Brian Hecht, a serial entrepreneur for nearly 20 years and advisor to many digital companies, including our own digital team. Brian, so why do you think right now the health sector is exploding so much?
Well, I think that since a few years ago, there's been this quantified self movement, which is that individuals really are, you know, becoming curious about how their bodies work, not just their weight and the number of steps they take in a day. But as the technology improves, we can, you know, begin to monitor really interesting things, how our sleep is, what our blood sugar is, even how our posture is. So now the technology is there to be able to measure these things. We can see these dashboards and these graphs to really consolidate that and get a picture of our bodies.
And it seems that when a company like Apple launches an entire operating system that has a chunk of it dedicated for health-related stuff, it validates the market, that it's not just the kind of really nerdy people like myself who want to keep track of my calories and my weight and stuff.
Sure. Well, you know you've hit it when Apple includes it on its home screen. I mean, their newest operating system has a little button, just like phone and calendar, that says health. And it aggregates all of the different data from all of the different apps or devices you might use. But it's going to go one step further. It's actually going to use their hardware to measure additional things. And then additionally, and you can look at it, but you can also share it with your doctor. And at some point, it'll probably also go to your insurance companies to help decide premiums. Now, they haven't announced that,
right,
but I wouldn't be surprised if it's heading in that direction.
So let's talk about a couple of apps in this space. First, Medicast. What is it?
Medicast is great. They started in Atlanta. They did an accelerator in Missouri, and now they're in Silicon Valley. They call themselves the Uber for healthcare. So they have an app that offers 24-hour on-demand house calls from real doctors that show up at your door within 2 hours of making the request.
This is how it used to happen, right?
That's right. It's a, you know, leave it to Beaver time, 50 years old. And that's what I love about it. It really uses technology to bring back a beloved and useful service that's sort of lost to the sands of time. But now it becomes practical again, given especially mobile technology.
Okay, so you can have a doctor show up. Will your insurance company pay for it?
It's not directly covered by insurance. It does cost the consumer. In one of the markets, they're about $250 per visit. But they do give you the paperwork. And honestly, if you compare it to the cost of going to an urgent care facility in the middle of the night, or you don't want to call your GP, it's actually a pretty good value.
Okay. Gym Pact?
Yeah, they just switched their name. They go by Pact now. This is really cool. They incentivize healthy behavior by allowing you to make bets, real money bets, both with yourself and with the community. So you set your own goals. I want to go to the gym. I want to track my nutrition. I want to eat 5 servings of veggies a day.
Right.
And you actually put your own money up. And if you make your goal, you keep your money. and if you lose it, you have to pay the money. And actually, if you make your goal, you get money out of the pool from the people who missed their goals.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So this is kind of behavioral economics, or modifying my behavior. And apparently, maybe kind of like how when we pay a physical trainer to yell at us and get us to exercise, it's a little different than when we just show up on the gym.
That's right. Well, you know, and a big motivator is if you've paid for the personal trainer, you don't show up, you pay anyway. And,
right,
you know, the behavioral economics angle came from the founders, who were two undergraduates at Harvard who studied behavioral economics. And they found out that not only do rewards incentivize good behavior, but punishment actually works even better. And although that sounds cruel and this is a more gentle approach, they found that the prospect of losing that $5 was more effective than the prospect of winning a dollar.
What are the kind of community members out there talking about and thinking about as this big change happens?
Well, I think the interesting thing is that all of these technology-enabled apps and so forth still rely on individual choices that people make. So they can encourage you or discourage you or share information with yourself or with your doctors. But in the end, it really comes down to choices you make about what you eat, about how you exercise, about how you live your life. And, there's all this hype about how this is going to change the landscape of health. But in the end, it's really just human behavior. It's really just trying to make it easier for you to track and monitor and change what you do.
All right, Brian Hecht, thanks so much.
Thank you. Yeah.